Hey everybody, I'm so glad we're all here at Aurora Kids Online. Woo! I am pumped to be here. Are you pumped to be here? I said, are you pumped to be here? That's what I'm talking about. We'll need that kind of enthusiasm because this month we're training for an epic, all-out, can you even imagine it, race extravaganza. And the first thing you need before you start a race is commitment. Commitment is making a plan and putting it into practice. It takes commitment to do all sorts of things, like homework, or being on a sports team, or drawing a masterpiece in chalk on your driveway, or running a 5K. We need commitment in our relationship with God, too. We need to put a plan into practice, so that way we can grow more like Him. Check out today's Big God Story.
The Bible. It's 66 books of history, stories, letters, and poetry that fit together to form God's one big story. The epic adventure of how He created us and loves us so much that He made a way to rescue us. As we travel through the Bible, from Genesis to Revelation, we discover people who met God and found their lives changed forever. Now, for an amazing story inspired by the book of 1 Corinthians, chapter 9, verses 24 through 25.
Did you know that some writers of the Bible talk sports? Well, not every sport, but at least one that you are familiar with. Yep, running. Running has been around ever since, well, since God created people. In fact, the Apostle Paul uses running as an example in one of his letters to the church in Corinth.
In a race, all the runners run, but only one gets the prize. You know that, don't you? So run in a way that will get you the prize.
Now, Paul is talking about more here than just running. But first, you have to understand what it takes to run a long race. Let's say you want to run a marathon. That's 26.2 miles. There's no way you can just hop up off the sofa where you've been playing video games for months and run that far. So, you need a plan. When I was preparing for my first marathon, I found this plan. I started training more than 4 months ahead of the race, and I started with just a few miles at a time. Once you've got a plan, well, then you gotta move. That means short runs, long runs, and cross training to work other muscles and prevent injury. Next up, you've got to fuel. Plenty of water, of course. Plus, you need healthy carbs for your long runs, like bananas. And maybe some spaghetti and meatballs.
What's the last part of your training? Get ready for it. Rest.
If you don't rest and let your body recover, you'll get burnt out or injured. The last few days before a marathon, you don't even run at all.
Oh, yeah. Running a long race is no joke. But Paul says what we're doing right now, you and me, is even more important.
All who take part in the games train hard. They do it to get a crown that will not last. But we do it to get a crown that will last forever. So I do not run like someone who doesn't run toward the finish line. I do not fight like a boxer who hits nothing but air.
Paul packs a lot of weight into just a few sentences. Whether you planned it or not, we are all running a race right now. Okay, so that's a little crazy. Clearly, I'm standing here talking to you, and you aren't outside running laps either. But Paul is talking about a way of life, a journey. We're all focused on the finish line, life forever with Jesus. But in the meantime, every step along the way is important as we live out what matters most. Jesus reminded his followers,
"Love the Lord your God with all your heart and with all your soul. Love him with all your mind. Love your neighbor as you love yourself."
Yep. Love God, love others. That's what matters on this journey together. But just like you can't skip from jogging one lap around the school gym to running a 26.2 mile race, you're gonna need some practice.
Your Love God, Love Others marathon needs a training plan.
Now, none of us have it all figured out, but here are four important things to start with. In fact, you may already be doing some of them. First point, hear. God is the master teller of this amazing story. He's the author of this whole race, so the most important thing is learning to hear from God. That means digging into God's word and hearing the stories and wisdom from people who walked with him. And you can also hear from God from people around you in your life who know and follow him. Now, here's the second step in training for our Love God, Love Others marathon. Pray. Okay, when you hear pray, you might think,
In nomine Patris et Filii et Spiritus Sancti.
Truth is, you don't need fancy words to pray. You can talk to God anytime, anywhere, about anything, just like talking to your mom or your best friend.
Now let's take a look at point three in our training plan, talk.
Hello out there!
Tell other people what God has been up to in your life, what's changing, how you're learning to love others better.
And here's the final point in your Love God, Love Others training plan, live.
Live for God. Let his love fill up every part of your life, at home, at school, at church, even when your dad makes you stop reading your book to play a game with your little sister. Hear, pray, talk, live. That's how you practice loving God and loving others. As Paul wrote,
So run in a way that will get you the prize. We do it to get a crown that will last forever.
And when you do, you will live out Paul's wisdom to the Corinthians and win the race.
What Paul wrote in his letter is so true. If you want to be strong as you run the race of life, that takes commitment. You have to keep practicing what matters most. Remember, Jesus told us what matters most, loving God and loving others. We can learn to live that out when we take our time to practice our training steps. Hear from God, pray to God, talk to God, and live for God. Maybe you already do all of those things, or some of those things, or maybe you're just getting started. Either way, we are all training together. It helps me when I remember that God is with me to help me with those steps and that I can trust him no matter what. Let's take a look at our memory verse for this month. It's from another one of Paul's letters in the New Testament, 1 Timothy 4:8. Read it with me. Training the body has some value, but being godly has value in every way. It promises help for the life you are now living and the life to come. 1 Timothy 4:8. That's right! Training your body is important if you want to run an actual race. But what matters most in life is understanding how much God loves you, then sharing his love with the others around you. Let's pray and ask God to help us do that. Dear God, thank you for always being with us. Thank you for giving us a race to run every single day. Help us to practice what matters most, loving you and loving other people. Help us to remember to hear from you, pray to you, talk about you, and live fully for you. We love you, God, and we pray these things in Jesus' name. Amen.